Okay, so I want to talk about Cape Touch and Atlas. I have a number of examples again of, well, Atlas examples. This time I'm going to try to switch to Atlas and do those examples live, even though they're on the slides. The reason I haven't done that in the past is because I get frazzled doing something like that, so please bear with me.
She's doing it because Jeff yelled at her, which is nothing that makes her frazzled.
Absolutely.
Fake news.
No, I, okay. So, yeah, by the way, the slides that you posted are the...
Yes, they're posted.
Can you post the handout version? Anyway.
I might not have.
Okay. So here's some topics I'm going to talk about. What is K in Atlas? If I enter a real form, how do I get a handle on K? K is a reductive real link group. How does Atlas think of K types and their highest weights? Given the parameter for a real form, how can I find the most K types of the representations using Atlas? And how to find the part of the K spectrum, multiplicities of K types up to some certain height? And then very little on what about K types of disconnected groups. I'm going to occasionally say a few words about what happens if K and G are disconnected. And for the most part, I'm going to focus on the connected case. Okay, so suppose we have a complex group as well in Atlas and a real form. Once we have a real form, we have a KGB, set KGB. And the real form determines a maximal compact, well, since I think it's complex, it's not compact, so I put maximal compact in quotation marks, up to conjugation by G. If X is a KGB element, and K is the fixed point of the corresponding data, K then is a complex reductive algebraic group, but it's not necessarily connected. And so it may not be an Atlas group, something that Atlas can directly talk about. K captures, as this was already said before, captures the disconnectedness of the real form. K mod, the connected component, is isomorphic to the real form. It has the same number of components. K is connected, and K is connected. I've already mentioned that earlier. Last week. Okay, so for example, if G of R is SL2R, then K is SL2C. If you have BGL2 or you want to think of it as SL2-1, then K is O2C, which is this one. That's K of R is in, well, the real form, meaning if you look at the intersection with the real form of G, then this is a maximal compact subgroup of G of R, and we have these. Okay, so the connected component is a connected reductive complex link group with its own root data, so Atlas can talk about that particular. And so if you choose X as a distinguished fiber, then Atlas can construct this group in the real form K naught of R, and that's the maximum compact subgroup of the connected component of the real group G. Okay, so choosing X carefully as before yields K naught in more familiar coordinates. Depending on how you choose your KGB element, your K is going to look more familiar or not, so the roots of K are going to be the ones that you're used to or not.
Can you, what's the other things? What is it not about X? You said K
if you like the ordinance, that's good.
The point is that when you introduce G, you identify the character lattice of a cartan with ZN. That's the choice of coordinates once and for all. And this K-naught is constructed out of that. And so its coordinates are built from those coordinates originally chosen for G. And the roots are some in the equal rank case, some subset of the roots for G. Which subset it is depends on which X you choose. And so, well, you have ZN and different possibilities for which the roots in K are. That's the...
Is it exactly the same as compact imaginary roots?
Yes.
Maybe rather than carefully, the better word would be wisely.
Could you print the compact imaginary roots for 0, 1, 2, and 3?
Sure. Okay, so the compact yes.
No idea.
This is what happened to me.
Well, they just do row of K of those guys.
That's
row of
part of the building. Oops. So A, B, B, G, zero. Oh, good.
That K is a complex group, possibly disconnected. Mm-hmm. Take a compact form of it. If the group's disconnected, that K will be disconnected. But in any event, the identity component of K is a connected algebraic group, and that's what this demand returns.
This is a compact group.
So this is a compact real group.
And so from Atlas's point of view, it's the complexification. But
you want to see it as a big one. I thought you just want a complex group.
Just to see what happens if we use a different KGB element. Well, I don't know. Okay, so Phil gave you SU2, but Silver Root, well, I don't want Silver Root, now the Silver Root is more classy. Okay, so let's do a different example, something that is maybe non-equivalent and not connected.
Wait, do you want to do PGL2 first? Is that what you're doing?
Well, I started with SP4, so I already started with the larger two.
Okay,
okay, so let's do that. I'm prepared to do GL3R, but we can also do PGL2. So what did I want to do?
So
okay, so
can I ask how you possess before? But when you chose a KGB element here, KCO, you asked for the simple roots. This is with respect to H intersection K. But
these are the simple roots of K naught. So it constructs this K naught, this new group. And this is how this is the in the coordinates that now Atlas picks for K naught, this is the root.
So there's X gives you an involution of H.
Yes.
And the positive roots are always the same, that's fixed. But which roots are compact and which roots are non-compact depends on theta. So if you choose zero, it says this root is compact, but if you choose X2, it says that root is compact.
So these are all in G.
They were originally, now they are in K.
Okay, so what is the contact for K?
Well, in the previous case, it was equal rank, so it was the original Cartan. The Cartan K, as you said, H intersects K, which is all of H in that example. In this example, H intersects K is smaller.
Okay. So if you change the KDH, so K will change.
Yes. It can change. The roots of it can change. All the groups that you get are isomorphic. In fact, conjugate. It's just giving you a different conjugate of the same group. Pardon me?
That's the same K0.
Yeah, if you take K0 of X1 or K0 of X2, you're getting two different conjugates of the same group.
Okay, in order to construct the K0, we need to take an X in the Swedish timer. And I guess in GL3R, we really only have one choice, even though 0, 1, and 2 are all attached to the fundamental Cartan. Only 0 is in the Swedish timer. So I guess we could just take a look at the...
What does that mean, the distinguished fiber for the choice?
Huh?
Why must we be a distinguished fiber to choose K?
You don't really have to, but it's too hard to think about other ones, so we just stick to that. You don't really need it, but it's a little too strong, but it's more than enough for what we need.
Okay, so if you pick a different KGB element. So we need to do something to get something. Okay, so now I have the K naught.
You just showed that the root would allow you to choose number one.
Right. So it has to be in the distinguished fiber. So what are the simple, I guess one thing to check is the compact action role. Okay, so this is row C for this. Now I have KGL. KGL is now my K0 for GL3. Compact not connected. Real group with linear algebra SP2, so this is SO3. just the connected home.
If you type right, from this, just for connection.
And so the simple. And you're not like this, but. It's something that maybe we can fix, so there's only one simple rule. This is a one by one matrix, so it actually, you know, pairs things down to.
Yeah, so this is a significant complication for us humans. When the group's not equal rank, the original group, in this case, has rank 3, and K only has rank 1. And so, this is a one vector, this is not a subset of the roots of G, and it's just a lot harder to think about. It is what it is.
But you can definitely make the ball show it with the same coordinates, because you can embed the top down with the small
thing.
Yes, but.
This is not a root for G.
It's Yeah, so there are commands, if you really want to get into it, there are commands which will do that, which will show you the roots of G and how they restrict the K, which is basically what you're asking. And so if you need that information, it's there.
There is a restriction matrix from 3 to 1.
Right.
Should definitely be given.
Okay, anything on this example? And I go back to my slides.
Yeah, you gotta fix that, Mark.
Okay.
Well, I think that's because of the specific choice of this projection.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's one thing I forgot. I was going to say, well, you know, what happens if you take K naught and then KGB, of course, there's only one element because it's a compact group. So, both David and Jeff have already talked about what's the clean way of parameterizing K types. Invisible implementations of POR using the notion, well, the clean way to do this is using the notion of minimum K types of certain standard modules. Just quickly review what those are, and I think David already defined those, but I think it's not a bad idea to review things. The lowest k-type of a standard or visible representation is a k-type which is minimal with respect to a certain norm, the Bowman norm. And this is how one can define that norm. You take the k highest weight, you add 2 more k, and take the inner product of itself. That's, of course, a finite number. Every standard or reducible module of G of R has a finite number of most K types, each with multiplicity 1. And the irreducible quotient has all the lowest K types in it. Okay, so certain tempered representations have unique lowest K types, as David and Jeff both have already explained, and you can use this fact to parameterize K types. And so here's the theorem, I think. That's what's coming. G be a real group, and apply the atlas of maximal compact subgroup K of R, and somehow in relation to theta. And then the theorem says that there's natural bijections between following two sets, tempered, irreducible representations of GR with real infinitesimal character, irreducible representations of K, meaning K types. And then parameters, the final limit parameters, these are the parameters which parameterize those tempered irreducible representations. And the bijection is, well, you take one of those parameters or attach the the corresponding irreducible representation, and then the unique host K type is the K type that is assigned to it. Okay, so atlas versions of these K conjugacy classes of discrete time limit time parameters are called K parameters, which parameterize the K types in atlas. Okay, so fix a real form. We have an associated set KGB. And the K parameter is an equivalence class of pairs X lambda, where X is a KGB element. Lambda is one of our lambdas, our parameters, which we've already seen, has to be in X in the character lattice plus roll. Of course, the new input our representation of our parameters equal to zero, so we need that out. The parameter in order has to satisfy the number of conditions. It has to be dominant, lambda has to be dominant for the imaginary groups. That is the standard condition. If alpha is real, then we have a parity condition, which makes the parameter final. And then we also have to make sure that the corresponding module is non-zero, so there is another condition on imaginary simple non-compact. Okay, equivalence of parameters is generated by these two things. Because lambda minus lambda, lambda is only defined up to 1 minus theta x upper star, and nobody was explained. And we can move x lambda to a different, by a cross action to a simple complex group. We simultaneously move x and lambda to get an equivalent representation and therefore an equivalent k-type. Okay. So if we have a k parameter, then we add mu is equal to zero, and that gives us a parameter for a inferred irreducible representation, I whatever you take, call it I of J in A different. Irreducible, the real infinitesimal character, has an individual. Having an equals K type tau. The corresponding atlas data type is K type. Actually, it was called K parameter earlier.
But so one atlas we think is a K type would be this part of the G, right? K lambda mu equals zero.
Atlas, K type is X and lambda. Okay, or X lambda.
We will not define something with respect to the given K on the specification of the quantum.
I mean, if you're asking the classification of K types is in terms of data for G.
Yes.
That's true. So it doesn't give you, I mean, it's in terms of G. Andre will get shortly to how you get something directly in K if you want.
You could define that same K type if you can realize that compact group as a maximum compact group of a different G, and then of course that would be a different X and lambda. Okay, so this gives a formal and clean parameterization of K types of all cases, including the disconnected case. Can be difficult to understand. We want to, most of us, at least I want to think of K types in terms of the highest weights. And so what are the highest weights corresponding to K type parameters in this way? Okay, so for instance, SL2, irreducible representation of SO2 may be given by integers as 1 for each integer. Tempered irreducible representations with real infinitesimal character are the discrete series. There are two limits of discrete series. And then there is a spherical principal series as infinitesimal character 0. And so we have to match those up. SO2 type with weights, positive integer, and then be assigned to the game parameter x e minus 1 with x HEL 1 0. And again, we've made here a choice. We're assuming that k, x equals 0 corresponds to the holomorphic discrete series with positive loads k x. Let's see, where was that? It's the limit, or the limit of the discrete series, the lowest k hat k has parameter x, k minus 1, 0. Okay, so you just take the 0 away, and that gives you parameter for the people. Okay, so if k is negative, and you switch the KGB element to the KGB element 1, and that gives the opposite discrete series, or limit of discrete series, would be appropriate.
I think that's a mistake. That should be k plus positive.
K, if k, oh, k is negative,
so
yeah.
K is positive, okay.
Yeah.
More readable as minus parentheses k.
I got myself.
Yeah.
Okay, so the trivial SO2 type is given by the k parameter x1, where x is the open KGB element 2, so this is the spherical principal series that infinitesimal tends to zero has lowest k times v equals k times the trivial. Okay, so now PTL2. Yeah.
I guess so. We saw with Dev also that, for example, for the discrete series also we have the one x, we write all the discrete series. And so I guess that something like that also happens here. We can use x equals 0 for a negative.
Well, we need our lambda to be dominant.
Oh.
And so, yeah, we're going to see that, you know, so if you look at highest weights later on, we can choose dx and also get negative numbers. But if you want our parameter to be standard, then we have to switch them. Okay, so now GMR is O2, so this is connected. The O2 types are, there's a trivial K type, there's a determinant of sine K type, and then there is one for each positive integer K, which has dimension, each of those has dimension 2. Restriction of those contain the SO2 types with corresponding to K and minus K. Okay, the irreducible tempered representation of the infinitesimal character of the discrete series with positive half integral horizontal parameters.
So the HP size is precisely.
Yes.
The two closed orders get glued together by the disconnected K.
Okay. And there's two minimal principal series at mu is equal to 0. And both of them are equal to 1. Okay. So the O2 type corresponding to K then corresponds to the K parameter x and K minus 1 over 2 is x to the closed part of 0. So these are the discrete series, there's no limit of discrete series yet. The trivial K type is corresponds to this K type X is the unique open orbit, so that's the principal series. That's all right. And the lambda has to be in, X star. So if you pick a lambda equal to rho, then you get the spherical representation. And then the other one, you have to choose, you have to add one to the lambda, which is other principle. Okay, this is this has the determinant character as well. Okay, so with this kind of parameterization, the nice thing about it is you need to come to those k-types of the standard or equivalent irreducible module, and so certainly in terms of this parameterization, the k-spectrum of the standard module does not depend on the continuous parameter, setting u equal to zero does not change the those k-types. And so, of course, making u equal to zero might make this module reducible. It also might make the parameter not final. And so what you do is you just finalize the parameter, which apples can do, and finalize. And so that might, the parameter might break down into a sum of parameters. And then, of course, nu stays zero. And so we just cut off the nu, the zero, in all of those parameters, and that gives us the lowest k types of that, in this representation of that standard model. Okay, so we do this by hand, shall we do this, illustrate how to do this by hand. So let's see. So we're going back to SL2R. Okay. Razzle the dynamic handling the light attack thing there. Okay. So I want to look at take the minimal principle series at the non-spherical principle series at infinitesimal parameter after to pick something.
What is the meaning of the command minimal principle series of the problem? What does the problem?
It finds the parameters of
the principle.
So it's just a convenient way to specify a parameter. You could do it by hand, but this
picks out the,
this helps you.
Yeah. Makes it easier.
So do it
again. You're
going to
write of G. I'm reading from the slide and then write the bottom.
Okay, so it picks out the open orbit for G, and so I guess that kind of is the shortcut. and now we have to enter a lambda. Like if I enter rho, I get the spherical principle series. I want the other one because I want something.